Welcome back, It's Not, and today we have another piece of God of War news to discuss. We are going to be talking about Housemarque's next project, and we are also going to be discussing Ratchet & Clank Rift Apart. Now, before we get into that, if you have not subscribed already, please hit that subscribe button, hit that notification bell to get notified about all my upcoming videos, and hit the like button. It helps the channel a ton. Now, let's get started with this God of War Ragnarok information that I've come across. Now, this originally comes from Reset Era, and of course, if you guys are familiar with Navtra, who we've talked about all week pretty much with the Final Fantasy news and previously before in other videos, has been a reliable source in the past and continues to be a reliable source today. And I have seen some talks about it on Twitter, saw a bunch of gaming outlets talking about this, and it all sources back to this September 17th, 2020 post made by Navtra, which says, "What I've been hearing for a while was that Miles Morales, Sackboy, and Horizon are cross-gen, and Demon's Souls, Ratchet, and God of War 2 are PS5 only. Does say bad info is always a possibility, but since everything else was basically confirmed yesterday, I find it hard to believe that God of War 2 is the outlier. Just wanted to clarify that." So this is a very interesting post. It's a very interesting piece of information because God of War Ragnarok has been a big question. It's been a big question. Is this a cross-gen game? Is this going to be a PS5 only game? A lot of people want this to be a PS5 only game, but as of right now, we don't have any information on that. The original teaser was really just the logo and a date, kind of a window, if you will, 2021 specifically, and we haven't heard anything since. Sony hasn't even addressed God of War in any way, shape, or form since that teaser. And I think there are a couple things in play here. Number one, I do begin to believe that God of War Ragnarok or God of War 5 or whatever you guys want to call it, the PS5 version of God of War is going to be a PS5 exclusive. I don't think it's going to be cross-gen. Originally, I thought with Horizon being cross-gen, could God of War be cross-gen as well? But I've come to the conclusion that I don't think this game is cross-gen. And bear with me here. I'm going to explain why I believe that to be the case. Number one, Horizon Forbidden West was developed as a PS4 game first, and then they transitioned it to be a PS5 title as well. God of War Ragnarok, I believe, has started off as a PS5 game to begin with. Now, originally, they probably planned for a 2021 release date, so that's why they did the teaser. Now, we have supply constraints with the PS5, and so there isn't as many PS5s out. I think it's something around 6 to 7 million consoles in players' hands, and that's assuming the scalpers are actually selling the consoles. So if that's the case, it would still be a little too soon to release God of War Ragnarok. What I think they're going to do instead is wait to get more consoles out there. Once they have about 15, 20 million consoles out there, which is very easy for Sony to do, as long as the supply constraints aren't there, then it would make sense to drop God of War Ragnarok, which makes it a 2022 game. And the reason I say that is because the supply constraints are expected to be a lot easier and less prominent in 2022. People are going to be able to get a hold of them a lot easier in 2022, so it makes sense for God of War Ragnarok to be a 2022 title. So I think Navtra is actually onto something. I think that Navtra is probably speaking the truth, at least based on their sources. I don't think that Navtra would just start spewing random nonsense if they didn't have sources that they believe to be accurate with their information. And again, this is after they know that Miles and Sackboy and Horizon were all cross-gen, and Demon's Souls and Ratchet were PS5 only. So it all comes together. That source must have been correct, because how could the one and only game that isn't accurate be God of War Ragnarok? It doesn't make any sense. So I think Navtra is accurate with this information, and I think that Navtra has proven themselves to be reliable with leaks and sources and stuff like that. So I'm quite confident that God of War Ragnarok will be a PS5 only title. Especially, we got to look at it like this too. As soon as games start to go into 2022, it starts to become a question of, can we really expect games to still be made for the PS4 from first party studios? I feel like that starts to become a question, and that falls in line here too. So God of War Ragnarok being pushed to 2022, there's a lot of reasoning behind it, and I think it makes sense. And ultimately, I also feel like sometime this year, they're probably going to give us a trailer of some sort with a new release window on it. and also stating it as a PS5 only game. But that's just a prediction on my end. I don't actually have any sources or anything like that that are saying that that's the case, but I believe that could happen, especially with it looking like it's going to be a 2022 title. Again, this is basically a rumor, so take it as you will. Don't expect this to be a fact and kind of expect nothing more than just a rumor from it so you don't get yourself too hyped up about it. Now, on to our next topic. This is all about Housemarque and them talking about their next game. We know Returnal was a big title. We know it did really well in reviews. And I think the sales are quite good too, given that it's only on PS5. So this comes from VideoGamesChronicle.com, titled Housemarque says it wants to create more bigger experiences like Returnal. So a senior director at Housemarque has indicated that the studio would like to create more large-scale games similar to Returnal in the future. Asked by Game Reactor what the company will do next, Housemarque's marketing director, Mikhail Haveri, indicated that it would like to take on another project similar to scale to Returnal, but didn't entirely rule out creating more of the smaller arcade shooters it's known for either. In quotes, "We've been working on two projects previously, and now with Returnal, we have, of course, only one project," he said. "It's hard to say if we will continue with one or two projects in the future, but the idea of us now being able to establish ourselves with Returnal will be defining the future type of titles we want to make." He added, "The idea is that we now want to show we're not just a Rezogun studio. We can do all kinds of things. And from our studio's perspective, that means that we want to go for these bigger types of experiences." Lastly, they note, "Now we still love arcade. We still love smaller games as well. Who knows, maybe 26 years in the future, we'll do more of that as well. But that really depends on how successful we are able to build ourselves with the types of experiences that Returnal now is presenting." And honestly, I feel like this is their best game they've ever made. I feel Returnal still to this day is my favorite game this year that I played. Completely and utterly, no game is, to me, a better experience than Returnal. Granted, keep in mind, I did not experience crashes. I did not experience any of the things that some people were experiencing. I had a very smooth experience with Returnal, not even one crash. It was a lot of fun for me. I really enjoyed the game, and I think Housemarque has created something really special with Returnal. Now, do I think they should do Returnal 2? Not necessarily. I feel like the game is good as is. Maybe they should move on to a new project. But if they did do a Returnal 2, I would be more than okay with that. But overall, I want to see them do projects on this scale. I really don't want to see them go back to arcade, like Rezogun type games. I feel like they're so much more capable of doing greater projects. And they've impressed me and surprised me with just how skilled they are. So I really want to see even more ambitious projects from them than Returnal. But overall, very impressed with Housemarque. I never was like a super big advocate for Housemarque, but after this project, yeah, they are an excellent studio and they've done an excellent job with Returnal. So kudos. I will definitely play anything else that they put out in the future. Now on to our last topic, and this is all about Ratchet & Clank. This is a minor topic, right? Basically, Ratchet & Clank Rift Apart has got an update uploaded to the servers and it's 39.7 gigabytes. And it's probably that day one update. I think that's the day one patch. You know, we're getting close to June and naturally these things start to get uploaded to the servers to be ready for people who are getting the games early to review them. They need to be playing it at the same level as somebody who's going to be playing it day one. That way, the experience is the same across the board and they can review it based on what consumers can expect day one. So this is probably just going to have the accessibility stuff, you know, polishing the game up. I think we're also going to be looking at some other stuff as well, like maybe photo mode or whatever else they're adding. I can't say for sure what it is, but I think that we're pretty much looking at that day one patch that you see with pretty much every game nowadays. So we'll be looking forward to this one. I can't wait to see what the reviews are like. I can't wait to play it myself. It's looking like a very promising project. Cannot wait for this title. But that's all I have for you guys in today's video. I'd love to hear from you. What do you think of this news coming from Reset Era about God of War Ragnarok being a PS5 only title? Do you believe that that will be the case? How do you feel about Housemarque and Returnal and their next project? Do you want to see them do something more ambitious or just as ambitious as Returnal? Or would you like them to go back to games like Rezogun? And lastly, what do you think could be in this Ratchet & Clank update? Or does it even really matter? Let me know in the comments. And as always, if you have not subscribed already, please hit that subscribe button, hit that notification bell to get notified about all my upcoming videos, and hit the like button. It helps the channel a ton. You can follow me on Twitter and Twitch. Links will be in the description. And share this video with a friend. I will talk to you all on the next one. Take care.